Network.
And I'm Jack B. Nimbell.
And we're here broadcasting our annual yearly newscast, paid for by viewers like you.
Cheapskates.
Unfortunately, last year our show was snowed out.
So, we're doing 2 years in one show.
Half a show.
What?
Yeah, we've been allowed 15 minutes this year instead of the usual half hour.
Why?
Low ratings. We only have 4 viewers.
But, there's only like 10 TVs in the entire country.
What's a TV?
Anyways, as always, here in the studio is Mr. Louis Cipher, our reporter in the field.
What's a studio?
And also, our meteorologist, Nori Storm.
I'm called a weatherman.
Okay then, here is one of the bigger stories of 1859. It concerns one John Brown and his raid on Harper's Ferry.
Brown is a radical abolitionist and had organized the raid to steal weapons for a slave uprising in Virginia.
Brown was quickly captured by Robert E. Lee. 8 of his men were killed, and Brown was captured and put on trial. He was convicted for treason, murder, and fomenting insurrection.
He was sentenced to be hanged. And with us now is a video from our archives, with our own Mr. Louis Cipher live on the scene of the execution.
Thanks, Jack. And I am now with John Brown, minutes before his execution. And he will be dead.
Okay.
So, Mr. Brown, why did you do it?
Well, I strongly disagree with slavery. I'm what you'd call a radical abolitionist. And I mean, I just wanted to do something to help the plight of the slaves.
Well, did you think of doing anything else? Like writing for your local newspaper or holding a peaceful protest?
No. The fastest and most efficient way to deal with slavery is through a violent slave uprising. Besides, I haven't killed anyone since Nam.
And by Nam, you mean Kansas in 1856, right?
Yeah, that too.
So you failed.
Correct.
And why is that?
Well, to be honest, it wasn't a very well thought out plan. Or well executed plan.
Puns.
That is really insensitive.
Sorry. Apology accepted.
So what exactly went wrong?
Well, I forgot to tell the slaves, so
yeah, that.
What?
Yeah, I forgot to inform the slaves that the revolt was going to happen, so.
That's pretty crucial. That's almost as important as an escape route.
Yeah. We didn't have one of those either.
Well, you can't really call it a successful revolt, can you?
Well, we did manage to kill a few of Robert E. Lee's men, so, I mean,
no.
That's a...
No. Robert E. Lee's troops killed 8 of your men.
Really?
Yes.
Really?
2 of them were your sons.
Wow. Wow. I really messed this one up, didn't I?
So, did the trial go well?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not.
Well, were you angry or upset at the verdict?
No. It's proof that our legal system works really, really well.
Well, there were rumors about you maybe fleeing the country. Is there any truth to these claims?
Well, a few of my northern friends, they tried to persuade me to run up to Canada. And, I mean, I've heard that they have some pretty great salmon there, and that the caribou hunt is amazing. But, I decided I'd rather stay here and accept my punishment and be a martyr for the anti-slavery cause.
So, this is our last question, Mr. Brown. What would you like to say to all those people who accuse you of being insane?
Well, I would like to look them straight in the eyes and say, I haven't done anything right since because pickles. And to all my followers out there, you know what I mean.
Yeah, I highly doubt that. Well, it looks like we're just about done here. I thank you for your time, Mr. Brown, and I will see you in paradise. For ANN News, this is Lucifer, signing out.
Mr. Executioner? I'm pretty thirsty. Can I have something to drink?
No. We cannot waste any more pure water to extract that.
That was completely inappropriate. We should have cut that video feed a long time ago.
What's a video feed?
Well, at least it's a nice day outside.
Shut up, Nori!
Hey, don't say that. I have self-esteem issues.
Just go back to the green screen, Nori.
What's a green screen?
Just get out!
Okie dokie.
Wait, what?
No, he wasn't talking to you. He was saying okie as in okay, not karaoke.
Oh, okay. Now here with us to comment on the John Brown scandal is Mr. Eli Tist, abolitionist from the North. And Southern farmer Miss Jezebel informed. So, Mr. Tist, what is your opinion on this controversial abolitionist?
I think John Brown was a hero.
Elaborate, please.
Oh, okay. Well, John Brown risked his life for the good of his fellow man. He realized how cruel and inhumane the institution of slavery is. And rather than stand around and wait for somebody else to do something about it, he took matters into his own hands. At least he tried to give slaves a fighting chance to throw off the chains of injustice.
And what do you have to say, misinformed?
I unagree completely. My sisters, Annabelle, Clarabelle, Jezebel, Carabelle, Sarabelle, Marybelle, and my brother Bob Bell all live on my pappy's plantation. And those slaves isn't people. They property. And without them, we couldn't run the farm. No well. Besides, our peculiar institution ain't hurting no one. All it's doing is keeping this country together.
No. It's tearing us apart. Most people in the North hate slavery, while you down south exploit thousands of Afro-Americans just so you take in more money. We can't have these sectional divisions. Otherwise, the country will be destroyed.
Eli brings up a good point, misinformed. What say you?
If you want to see the country be destroyed, look no further than your hero, John Brown. No matter which way you slice a squirrel and rhubarb pie, what John Brown did was treason. It was against the law, and you Northerners think it's okay to break the law if it suits you. And as far as the divides go, it's your unjust attacks on the perfectly legal establishment of slavery that's causing these problems. Your Northern insolence is driving us apart.
Really, huh? Is it really wrong to try and free a fellow human being from unjust attacks on his natural rights?
Well, it looks like that's all the time we have for this section.
No, I went to college. You can't do this to me. You need to let me finish rebutting.
I'm sorry, but we're out of time, Mr. Tist.
No, you listen to me. I will not be made a fool out of. I challenge you to a duel, Miss Jezebel informed. Fight me, Dave!
So this is how you want to do it. You picked the wrong woman to mess with!
In the words of the great John Brown, I haven't done anything right since because pickles.
Oh no, not again! How could this have happened? Nori, I thought I put you on security duty.
What? Security duty?
Oh, come on! That's not even technological!
Jack, what are technical difficulties?
Oh, what is this? I don't even...
This is why we don't get any funding.
Well, it's not my fault all of our guests exploit the Second Amendment.
Well, now that some more of our precious time has been wasted, let's go to our weather forecast with Nori Storm.
Thanks, Carrie. I'm Nori Storm, and here is the weather report. Since we missed last year, I now present to you the two previous years' forecasts. That sure was weather. Now grab a pencil and paper, because here comes the upcoming year's forecast. Did you catch it? Back to you, Jack.
Thanks, Nori. I'll be sure to pack my coat, umbrella, and sunscreen with me this year.
In other, less frivolous news, the presidential election happened in 1860.
Yay!
The end result of this very divisive election was that Abraham Lincoln of Illinois was elected president. The election clearly showed how divided the country was in terms of political opinion. The well-established Democratic Party split into two factions, the Northern Democrats, who nominated moderate Stephen Douglas, and the Southern Democrats, who nominated the pro-slavery John C. Breckinridge.
Yep, and just for kicks and giggles, some Southern Whigs formed the Constitutional Union Party, which was loyal to the Union, and then they threw their candidate, John Bell, into the mix. But, in the end, it was Lincoln and the Republicans who emerged victorious.
Here now to comment on the election and plans for the future, President-elect Abraham Lincoln.
Welcome to the show, Mr. Almost President.
Thanks, Carrie and Jack. I'm almost happy to be here.
So, Mr. Lincoln, what was your strategy to win the election?
Well, the Republicans expected to get the support of the same states they had in the 1856 election. We also concentrated on gaining the support of Indiana, Illinois, and Pennsylvania. And with the division in the Democratic vote, a Republican victory was sure to happen.
So, Mr. President-elect, what did you do when you found out you won?
I'm very happy you asked that. Let me portray to you what I did on the night of the election. Let's let this bowl of popcorn represent a bowl of confetti.
Why don't you just use a bowl of confetti then?
I'm papyrophobic.
Wait, then did you actually use popcorn that night?
Yes, but I pretended that it was confetti.
Okay, proceed.
And let's let this recent newspaper represent the newspaper of the day.
Hold on, I thought you just said you were papyrophobic.
I cannot tell a lie. I'm a microphobic papyrophobe.
Okay, go on.
And this was the reaction I made when I read that I had won.
Yeah! Oh my gosh! I can't believe I won! Oh, I'm so grateful! I can't believe I won! Yeah!
John Brown, his raid.
Oh, please. That happened ages ago.
Just answer the question.
I believe John Brown's raid was the gravest of crimes.
So, Mr. Lincoln, what exactly do you plan to do once you take office?
Well, what I don't plan to do is let slavery go into the West.
That's cute. But that wasn't the question.
I plan on raising tariffs and helping with internal improvements. But first and foremost, I plan on seeing this nation succeed.
What is your opinion on the sharp divide between the North and the South?
A house divided against itself cannot stand. I believe this government cannot endure half slave and half free. I do not expect the Union to be dissolved. I do not expect the House to fall. But I do expect it to cease to be divided. It will become all one thing or all the other.
What? Could you not answer the questions in metaphors? It's really confusing.
Oh, okay. Well, 47 years ago...
You mean in 1773?
What? Whoa, my math was way off there. I wasn't even close.
Yep.
Well, the point of it all is this nation is not going to succeed because we're so bitterly divided over the issue of slavery. But in the end, we will all be slave or free. But in the end, we will be unified.
South's talks of succeeding.
Oh, please! That's not going to happen. They've been talking about seceding for years. They're like the boy who cried wolf. They just want attention. It's not happening.
Whoop! Free
breaking news, Mr. Lincoln. We just got word that South Carolina has seceded from the Union, and 6 other states are poised to follow.
My country is in need of me. Hey guys, there's like 20 seconds left in the show.
Well, it seems like we only have 15 seconds of airtime left, so,
what's airtime?
Well, it looks like you're gonna have to tune in next year to see what happens next. For ANN News, I'm Jack B. Nimble.
And I'm Carrie Oakley. Good night, and have a pleasant tomorrow.